come to you with praises. We've come to you with thanksgiving. Oh Lord, would you receive our sacrifices this morning in the name of Jesus. Lord, thank you, Lord, for giving up your life for us, oh God. Lord, thank you for loving us that much, oh God. And today we come in remembrance of that, what you did on for us on the cross, oh God. And Lord, we are eternally grateful. We are eternally grateful, oh God. We give you praise, Lord. We give you honor in the name of Jesus. Come on, appreciate the Lord. He deserves all the glory. He deserves all the honor this morning. Lord, we give you praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. There's no one who can stand beside you, oh God. No one can compare to your power, oh God. You are everlasting to everlasting, oh God. You are the King of glory. You are the Lion of the tribe of Judah, Lord. There is no one like you, Jesus.
Oh,
merciful Savior, we look up to you. We give you glory. We give you worship, Lord. Thank you for healing us, oh God. Oh, Jesus. The doctors, God, had written us off, oh God. But Lord, you came, Lord, and pulled us, oh Jehovah. And you healed us, oh God. Thank you, Jesus. You have taken care of the orphans, oh God. The widows and the widowers, oh God. What can we render to you this morning, oh God? Our hearts are full of thanksgiving, Jehovah. We give you praise, Lord. We worship you, Jesus. Redeemer and friend,
Hallelujah, church.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Wangapi wamebarikiwa kuwa hapa? Fanyie tu hivi. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Why don't you welcome your neighbor with a smile? Hallelujah. As we praise the Lord this morning, why don't you welcome the other neighbor with a good smile? Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Man, let's go. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. We just want to tell God that no one can do all the things that He has done in our lives. Hallelujah. Hey. Hey. Hallelujah. Are you ready to tell God that no one can do anything? Hallelujah.
You love my mind, and I am.
the Lord. Kila mtu tunaenda tu pole pole. Twende. Somebody just raise your hand before the Lord as we praise him one more time. Hey, hallelujah. Amen. Are you ready? Are you ready?
Amen.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We adore you, Jesus. Thank you for your love. You deserve all our praises. Lord, we thank you. Hallelujah. Father, we worship you this morning. We lift your name, Abba Father. Hallelujah. worship this morning. Just worship the Lord this morning. My worship belongs to the Lord. My worship belongs to Yahweh. My worship belongs to Emmanuel. God is in this place with us this morning. God, we worship you. We call you Father. We call you Yahweh. We call you Ebenezer. Worship belongs to you. Just take time and worship the Lord. Have time to speak to the Father. Have time to speak to the Almighty. God, we raise a banner of life in this place. We raise a banner of life in this sanctuary today. Our praises await you, Lord. Our worship awaits you, King of Kings. Thank you for who you are, our Master. Hallelujah. Lord, we love you. We love you this morning. We glorify your name. Just speak to the Lord. Just worship the Father. He's a merciful God. We are here because God has been. We are here because God is in the house to save the lost, to heal the sick, and to break every bondage in our lives. Many of us are partakers of those testimonies because the Lord has been good to us. The Lord has walked with us. God, we thank you. We love you this morning. Just love the Lord this morning, church. Just love the Lord this morning. God is here to speak to you. This is a worship experience like no other. The Lord is here to deal with the issues of our hearts. God, we raise our hands to you. Father, Father, this worship belongs to you. From our hearts, from the depth of our souls, this worship belongs to you. This worship belongs to you. And we bow before your presence to give you all the glory, honor, and praise. This worship is yours, O God. This worship is yours, King of Kings. We give you all the glory, honor, and praise. Hallelujah.
Tukisema we Bwana, katuokoa kutoka mautini. Tunasema we Bwana, tunakiri uwezo wako.
Tukisema e Bwana,
katuokoa. tunasema
tunasema e Bwana
tunakiri
tunakiri uwezo wako
wewe watosha
We worship you, Lord God Almighty. We worship you because you are the King of Kings. You are the Lord of Lords. We worship you because you have conquered this morning. We worship you, Lord God Almighty, because you are the banner of our salvation, O Lord. This morning, Lord God Almighty, you have victory at your hand, O God, because you have risen from the dead. We have come, O Lord God Almighty, not to witness, my God, but we have come to testify that you are the living God. Come on, just open your mouth and worship God. He is the living God. We are here because he is living. He is living this morning. We are here, Lord God Almighty. His presence is with us, O Lord. Therefore, we worship you, my Father. We worship you, my Lord. We worship you, my Redeemer. We worship you, my Lord God Almighty. You are Lord God Almighty. There is no other God who can be compared unto thee, Lord. There is no other God who can be compared unto thee. Even death could not hold you, Jesus. Even death could not hold you, my Lord. Death could not hold you. Death could not hold you. What is the Lamb of God? What is the Lamb who was slain? What is the Lamb who was slain for our salvation? We honor the Lord. We honor the Lord. We honor the God of love. The Bible says that while you are still sinners, yet you already died on the cross for us. Today we stand free, Lord. Today we stand free. Every chain has been broken because of the works of the cross. We celebrate you, King of all glory. We celebrate your victory today, my Lord, because it is our victory, my Father. We celebrate you, Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. The book of John, chapter 20, verse 11, the Bible talks about Mary Magdalene. I'll read from NIV. Now Mary stood outside the tomb crying. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb and saw two angels in white, seated where Jesus' body had been, one at the head and the other at the foot. They asked her, "Woman, why are you crying?" "They have taken my Lord away," she said, "and I don't know where they have put him." At this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not realize that it was Jesus. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Praise the name of our Lord Jesus. Today, we want not to be like the other disciples who went to see Jesus. They went to testify that which had been said. They went to confirm if that what Jesus had said was true. We want to be like Mary Magdalene. We have not come here to testify. We have come here that we may meet Jesus. Because he is risen. And I want us, even as we pray, may we pray that we may meet Jesus. We shall wait because we know he is alive. Amen. Amen. We want to pray for our country. We want to pray for the strikes, that is the doctor strike that has been ongoing for a very long time. And the nation is suffering. We are suffering. We want to call unto God that he may come and bring an agreement between the employers and the employees. We want to pray even of our roads. It's just the month of March, yet we have witnessed so many road accidents. May the Lord reign over our roads. May the Lord reign over our roads. Today, as we celebrate the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, we celebrate with a renewed hope. And that is a renewed hope that we are praying even as a people, that every situation in our lives will also be risen. We pray that even our plans to go to the former container's place shall materialize at the dates which we have planned. Amen. Nothing shall come between our plan and the God's plan. Our plan and God's plan is one. This is our year. We are taking the new territory. And His reason, we have a renewed hope. We are going. Amen. So I just want us to pray. Over all these things, we are also remembering Anne Dambu, who has been admitted at Nairobi Hospital. And she has been discharged. We are praising God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. We are praising God. On the same note, we pray for her, for strength, for comfort, and for peace, for she has lost her sister. We pray for Nancy Omamo, who's also lost her father. We pray for Daniel Jalongo, who's lost the sister. We pray for Deacon Esther as she continues to recover at home. We pray for Catherine Mwangangi, who is unwell, and also our son, who is sick, and the niece, who is in ICU at Aga Khan Hospital. Our Lord is able. He is risen. He shall do it. We pray for Joyce Mutua, who lost her dear mom yesterday. We have so many people to pray for, but we know, because He's risen, we have eternal hope. We have eternal hope. Our suffering is only for a time. We shall celebrate with Him eternally because He is risen. And in a few days, He shall be seated at the right hand of the Father. He shall be interceding for us. And even this shall be no more. So let us just open our mouth and remember all these things in prayer. You are a good God. You are a loving master. The Lord God Almighty, who is slow to anger. You are full of compassion, my Father. We've come unto you, King of all glory, because you are the rock of ages. You are the Lord who never changes. The Lord who was, who is, and forever shall be, my Father. We have come, King of all glory, just as you are able to fulfill the prophecies of the prophets, my God. Therefore shall you fulfill your word unto our lives, King of all kings of God. You say, my Father and my God, that this nation is yours, O God, and these people are your people, God. Therefore, we pray, my God and my King, even over our doctors, King of all glory. We pray, Jehovah, King of all kings, that we shall not lose people. Lives shall not be lost, O God. People shall not, O God, Jehovah, sink, my Father, in sicknesses, King of all kings, because the doctors are on strike, my Father. But we pray, Lord God Almighty, that you are going to intervene, O God. For where you are, Jehovah, Lord God Almighty, you bring solutions, oh God, where you are, King of all glory. Even though we could be in the boat, oh God, and the storms could be beating us, my Father, just by your word, oh God, today, like the disciples, oh God, we are crying out to you, Master. We are crying out to you, Master, oh God. Shall you not calm this storm, oh my Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ? We bless your name, King of all kings, even as we pray, oh God, of a protection of our roads, my Father. We have witnessed so many accidents, oh God. We have lost so many lives, my Father. We come, oh King of all glory, Jehovah, to refuse and to nullify premature deaths, oh God, my Father and my God, because the powers of the enemy are defeated, oh God. Therefore we shall not fear. We shall not travel in fear, my God. We shall not move about in fear, because you are our conqueror, Lord. You are our conqueror, Jehovah. You've done it again, oh Jesus. You've done it again, my Father, as you did it unto the people of the Israelites, oh God. So have you done it unto us, oh Jesus. We bless your name, oh God. We thank you, Jesus, oh God. Even as a church, we continue to thank you, Lord. We continue to thank you for the provision of containers, my Father. We continue to pray for resources. We continue to pray for the plans. We pray for the people who are involved, oh God, in making it a church, my Father. We pray, King of all glory, Jehovah, that indeed it shall be your sanctuary, my Father. It shall be our place of refuge, oh God. It shall be our place of help, my Father. It shall be our place of healing, in the name of our Lord Jesus. We thank you and we worship you, Lord. We bring unto you and thank you, my Father. We thank you, Jehovah, for the healing power, Jehovah, and we pray for full restoration, oh God, in the name of our Lord Jesus. We pray for full restoration, my Father. We pray for full restoration of our health, oh God, because you are able, my God. We pray for Catherine, my God. We pray for her son, and we pray, my Father, even for the niece, King of all glory. We know, Jehovah, that victory awaits. Victory awaits. Victory awaits in the name of our Lord Jesus. Victory awaits, oh God, even in our situations, my Father. Today, King of all glory, we've come, oh God, into your sanctuary, and we bless you, oh God, Jehovah, for your presence that is with us, oh God. We pray, Lord God Almighty, we shall leave this place, oh God, like Mary Magdalene, oh God, to testify that indeed we have seen him, that indeed we have heard of him, oh God. We have heard his voice. We have heard his reassuring voice. He is risen, Jesus. He is risen. Our Lord is not dead. Our Lord is not dead. And because he lives, we shall face tomorrow. Because he lives, we shall face tomorrow. Because you live, Jesus, we shall face tomorrow. We thank you and we worship you. We bless your name, O God. Because as you took away the keys of the gates of hell, of heads, O God, so our sins, O God, were defeated, my Father. You have given us redemption, O God, and we shall walk, O God, in your victory, my Father. We declare, my God and my King, O God, even as we repent, O God, before you, we shall not walk in condemnation. For your grace is at work in our lives. We thank you and we worship you. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray as we believe. Amen. Amen. Why can't we get a better clap for Jesus?
Hallelujah.
Welcome to Worship Experience Sitam Embakasi on the 31st of March 2024. Kindly welcome your neighbor and tell them, Karibu Nyumbani. We may have our seats even as we appreciate our wonderful, marvelous Sita Mbakasi Yada praise team. Kindly let us appreciate them. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. Redeemed people of God, it is my first time here. I therefore urge you, please, encourage me. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Today is a good day, is it not?
Yes.
He is.
He is.
He is.
He
is. He is. If you read from Matthew 28, 5 to 6, actually the angel said, do not be afraid. Do not, because he is risen. We want to take this opportunity once again to welcome you to this special Sunday edition. This is a worship experience / the Easter cantata. Cantata. Amen. We want to take this opportunity to appreciate those of us who could be fellowshipping with us or worshiping with us for the very first time. Do we have our esteemed DRS guest today? Just by a show of hands, kindly allow us to recognize your presence. If you're there, if you're there. Okay, you know I'm short-sighted. Come on, Mimi. Right. Please forgive me if you're there and I've not seen you. My eyes can't see far, but I've not seen anyone. We thank God. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. As I said, it's a special day. I also do not want to take much of our time. You can see there's some arrangement ongoing here. So we are going to have our notices being rolled out, and at the same time, we shall have our offerings. We shall have the notices being rolled out at the same time with the offerings. because immediately after that, we shall be welcoming the Easter Cantata team. This is the Sitam Embakasi youth team, the Sitam Embakasi media crew, the Sitam Embakasi Yada priest team in collaboration, coming together to minister unto us. And therefore, I'll just request us to sit, relax, and reflect as we reminisce on the last few moments of our Lord Jesus Christ here on earth. Amen? So I'll welcome the media team kindly. Let us roll out the announcements as our ushers wait on us.
Welcome to Sitam Embakasi, where Christ is the answer. Thank you for choosing to worship with us today. Our services are as follows. We have our Sunday intercessory prayer hour from 7:15 a.m. to 8:15 a.m. Our Wednesday prayer services are from 5:55 p.m. to 7:15 p.m. Our Thursday lunch hour prayer session is from 12:45 p.m. to 1:45 p.m. We have Shekinah Glory prayer hour every weekday from 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. Youth service runs every Sunday from 8:30 a.m. to 10:30 a.m., except for the first Sunday of the month. Subsequently, we have our youth Bible study from 11:30 a.m. to 1 p.m. Our theme for this year is Taking New Territories from Romans chapter 15, verse 20, and the theme for our first quarter of the year is Preparing to Take New Territories. You can give your tithe and offering through Mpesa paybill number 933333. That is 933333. Account, tithe, offering, ministry payment, or gifts. You can drop your hard cash in the offering basket circulating. You can also swipe your card through the PDQ machine at the reception. Draw a check in favor of Christ is the Answer Ministries, and at the back of the check, write Sitam Embakasi and your phone number. For bank transfers, kindly get in touch with the information desk after the service. The following are this week's announcements. We shall be handling obstacles to taking new territories, which is a sub-theme for the second quarter for the Wednesday midweek prayer services. The Youth Ministry notifies parents of the Southern Region Youth Conference scheduled for the 18th of April till the 20th of April 2024. This conference is for university, college, and high school going students. Parents are requested to register with 500 Kenya shillings only. The Social Action and Advocacy Ministry are recruiting medical and legal professionals to help in the forthcoming free medical and legal aid camp on the 13th of April 2024. This will take place in the new Sitam Embakasi premises, which is the former containers, from 10 a.m. The ushers and the team are currently giving out forms for you to fill. Kindly reach out and register. We would like to appreciate those who gave and attended our first Injilium Taani of the year, which happened on the 23rd of March 2024, where we were able to bring 76 souls to the Lord. Thank you for your continuous support, and God bless you. The Christian Education Department welcomes those who have attended Sitam Embakasi for at least a year for a membership intake class on the 7th of April 2024. You all are welcome. The CED welcomes members to register for the School of Ministry and Leadership Development Program, SMLD, beginning on the 30th of March, 2024. Come and get your leadership skills sharpened. Some of the renowned speakers are Professor Dionysius Kiambi, who is the current VC, Park University, Dr. Joy Mindo, Dr. Andani, Dr. Fidel Baraza, Dr. Njeri Gachohi, among others. We invite parents to register for baby dedication class on the 13th of April and an actual dedication on the 21st of April, 2024. We shall have a baptism by immersion class on the 21st of April, 2024, and the actual baptism on the 28th of April. Interested candidates do register at the information desk.
Sitem Embakasi Yada Praise Team are planning to do a music recording project. They are therefore requesting for donations in kind or monetary. Our budget is 517,000 Kenya shillings. You can channel your donations through paybill number 933-333. Account choir. God bless you and thank you in advance.
The youth ministry invites you all to an evening of worship sing-along dubbed Join in Praise, where generations join hands to praise the Lord on Friday, the 5th of April, 2024, from 6 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. This will be under the theme, Open Heavens. Come ignited and live impacted.
The Deacon Board has scheduled and hereby gives notice that the 5th Regional Annual General Meetings, RAGMs, for the year ended 31st December 2023 will be held both in person and virtually through a Zoom link to be provided for each RAGM for the following dates. Southern Region, which covers Sitam Karen, Athi River, Ngong, Buruburu, Embakasi, Rongai, Kagundo Road, Kitengela, Mombasa, Machakos and Syokimau on 6th of April 2024, starting at 9 a.m. East African time. Sitam East Timor will also join this RAGM. All Sitam registered members are eligible to attend their respective regional meetings. Any AOBs covering the regional matters should be sent to admin@sitam.org to be received at least 7 days before the meeting. God bless you as you plan to attend these governance meetings for the ministry.
Under the hand of Deacon Martin Munyu, Church Secretary.
Special greetings to you in the name of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. What a great joy and privilege it is for us to be alive today and to see the kind of things that we are seeing. Indeed, we live in moments that God is at work, both in our lives as individuals, but also in Sitam-wide as a ministry. We've seen His favor as we've initiated new congregations, and the way those congregations have grown in numbers, at the same time our older congregations are getting established, and we are seeing the Lord intervening as the numbers also grow among the older congregations. This is a sign that God is with us, and more we are moving towards each county as slowly by slowly the Lord gives us the opportunity to begin taking new territories in county headquarters. And more recently, we have begun reflecting again on what the Lord started to do a few years ago. We had embarked on a project that we called Moving the Ark, which was an initiative to establish our assemblies, at least five of them, in sanctuaries and buildings. We were able to do two, Sitam Ngong and Sitam Parklands, but then we were not able to continue. And currently we are in a state where we want to move 23 of our assemblies into more permanent buildings, and we feel it is doable.
Amen. During my membership in this place, I've witnessed the number of people increasing, as a result of which you find that this created a challenge of parking facilities.
We do not have any more space left in the tent. Congregants are following services from outside the tents and online, and it's very hot.
I cannot wait for the new sanctuary where there will be more space for everybody.
We are squeezed in our current premises. With the bigger premises, we'll be able to reach more people and even accommodate more people.
We are looking forward to a time when we can permanently own this facility, and as soon as possible, so that we can now put up permanent structures and plan adequately for the growth of the church.
The church was launched on the 9th of June in the year 2019. We are, from then until now, hosted at the Green Garden School in Kikuyu Town, The numbers have risen, and I would bet the church would have grown much more numerically if we had our own space that is sufficient and a bit expanded.
CITAM has about 60,000 members. And if we only had 25,000 members of CITAM making a commitment that each of them was going to give 50,000 shillings per year within a short period of time. As a matter of fact, if we give 50,000 per year and another 50,000 per year, in 2 years' time, 25,000 people actively participating, we actually would be able to raise 2.5 billion shillings. And if we are able to raise 2.5 billion shillings, we can establish all our 23 assemblies, both in their permanent sanctuaries, but also those that do need land, will bought land to settle them. And so we want to invite you to participate with us in this initiative that we are calling Together in Generosity, that you as an individual would generously make a commitment to pledge a certain amount of money that you'll give in 2024, and another amount that you'll give in 2025, and we believe within 2 years' time, we will be able to raise 2.5 billion that we can actually use to establish all our assemblies. So do please join us. Paul the Apostle wrote and said, you will be enriched in every way so that you can be generous on every occasion, and through us, your generosity will result in thanksgiving to God. And may God bless you as you take step to make this commitment a reality in your life. Thank you very much.
Fill the pledge form. Give via M-Pesa, check, money transfer, and cash through designated envelope. You can also give in kind.
Together.
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 In generosity.
In generosity.
In generosity.
Together. In generosity.
You can follow us on all our social media platforms, Facebook, X, which is Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and TikTok at CITAM Embakasi.
God bless you and have a fruitful and productive week ahead.
Amen. Thank you so much. Let us pray for offering. You are the giver of life and wealth. We bless you, King of all glory. You demonstrated giving unto us, O God, by giving your only begotten Son, O God. And therefore, Jehovah, my Father, these offerings, these tithes, we pray that you may bless them, bless where they came from, O God, and multiply, my God, and that even next time we may be able to have something to give in your house. This we pray, trust in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Karibuni.
Father, the hour has come. My soul is overwhelmed to sorrow to the point of death. My disciples won't even wait with me. They fall asleep at this critical time. They can't even keep watch with me for an hour. Father, may they have strength to watch and pray so that they may not fall into temptation. I know their spirit is willing, but their flesh is weak. I will remain in this world no longer, but they are still in this world. And I am coming to you, Father. Please protect them by the power of your name, the name you gave me, so that they may be one as we are one. Father, if it is possible, may this cup be taken from me. Yet not my will, but your will. If it is not possible, Father, for this cup to be taken away unless I drink it, may your will be done.
Ni mimi nimekupa we uzuni kiasi hicho dhambi mingi maombi hayatoki nisamehe baba uchovu na uvivu umenijaza moyoni sina amani nauma unipe raha
Thank you.
Kisiya soni kumama papa awe kumama papa
nazanga bomwana kumama papa
awe
kumama papa
kisiya soni
kumama papa
Yeah. you have just witnessed at Calvary, brethren, was the beginning of your redemption, your restoration, and salvation. But it is not quite over yet. The best is yet to come. So, sit back, relax, and enjoy the glory of your salvation.
Yeah.
job. He has been deceiving.
Deceiving.
Destroying.
Destroying.
And most importantly, misleading.
Misleading.
Most of you.
Oh, all of you.
To this place. And this new guy has a good job. How many are there?
No,
I
haven't.
Out of betrayal.
Yes, that's the one you are left.
Sir, yes, sir.
charges kwa sababu wewe wewe ni bosi bosi.
Tuambie vile ulifanya.
Aya.
Tueleze.
Extortion.
Extortion.
Robbery and violence.
Violence and robbery.
Walaisi nini? Walaisi kwa walaisi nini?
Waja 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 waja. Very deep.
Mwizi wa pale ya carbs. Mwizi wa
pale. Ni siku wanaipa. Walaisi kwa naipa.
Alafu kuna moja hapa interesting. Chongori the Lord.
Nimefanya kitu mbaya. Mimi sijafanya kitu mbaya. Si hata wewe ungefanya hivyo walai.
Noma sana, noma sana. Kuja hapa. Noma sana. Aya ya 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 ya. Noma sana.
Walai, walai.
Toka hapo ndani huko.
Walai huko. Kuna kwa. Sasa. Ni wala makilani. I was thinking. Sasa hizo. Walai. Moja moja kwa
moja. Wewe, enda uzie sasa hiyo tiko ndani.
Walai, hizo
walai Lucas.
Wonderful.
Maja. Send this mask to go on your left. Send that.
Send.
Send this mask to go on your left.
Sir, sir, present, sir.
Uja hapa. Mama. Mama. Send that. Dimensia. Send. Extortion, robbery with violence.
Robbery with violence, saints. Robbery with violence.
Alafu kuna petty thief.
Saints.
Yani ile simu ilikuwa ni kwa kesi ya watu walikuwa naiba.
Saints
thief. Alafu repentance at the cross. Repentance at the cross. Nimesha kuja hapa. Hizi ni nini unaandika pale? Hii ni nini? Hii ni nini?
My sincere and deepest apologies. Makosa ni yangu. There was a bit of a mix-up. Sorry, we got the communication a bit late. But you are the chief guest of our master. You are going to dine with him today. Today, say.
Today!
Ah!
kwanza songa hapa wewe.
Wewe ni tu bana.
Ngoja kwanza. Wewe unatusumbua sana na uliiba. Mwizi. Are you familiar with the justification by faith?
Justification by faith.
No. Are you familiar with the doctrine of baptism by water?
Baptism by water.
No. Do you attend any Bible study?
Ah, okay, okay, Bible study. Okay, ST.
ST?
No.
Yeah, it's a no.
Do you serve as a... Okay, okay, come on, you're there. Okay, okay, okay. Do you serve in any ministry? No. Then
how
did you get it? I didn't know heaven. You went to paradise. Ulibaka aje. Ama uliiba. Ama uliiba.
Uni wizi.
Ngoja, unaenda wizi hadi Hades.
Special
gift must be. Show us your ways, master. You wenyewe ni ulipataje hiyo kitu? Hebu tuambie ulipataje.
Tuambie tu vile ulipata hiyo
gift. I never stole this card.
Yeah.
I was given this card by the person on the middle of the cross. They call him Jesus Christ. He invited me to heaven and he told me that I will be with him in paradise. I never stole this card.
It doesn't matter. And it's you. I was given this by school. It's dead.
Very dead.
Very dead.
My father, my sister, is kuja hapo wewe. Kuja hapo wewe. Kuja. Nikuja pole pole bwana. Nikuja pole pole bwana. Twende. Kuna nguvu bwana. Pole pole bwana. Ai, twende bwana.
My son, come.
But master, I'm filthy. I sinned all my life, and I'm not worthy.
That is what you once were, but not any longer. This day, I have justified you. You're free by my grace. Through redemption, I have paid the price.
Tingamalu, tera adiane dala. Tingamalu, tera adiane dala.
Tingamalu,
tingamalu, tinga,
tingamalu,
tinga, tera adiane dala.
Tingamalu,
tinga.
So then, you men and women, hear me. Just as you receive Christ Jesus, I, as Lord, continue to live your lives rooted and built up in Him, strengthened in the faith, just as you were taught, and overflowing with thankfulness. See to it that no one takes you captive through hollow and deceptive philosophy, which relies on human tradition
and the elemental spiritual forces of this world rather than I, Christ. When you were dead in your sins and carnality, God made you alive with Christ. He forgave us all our sins, having canceled the charge of legal indebtedness, which stood against us and condemned us. He has taken it away, nailing it to the cross. And having disarmed the powers and authorities, he made a public spectacle of them, triumphing over them by the cross. And now, it is truly finished.
When the enemy thought he was winning, when the enemy thought he was winning, when the enemy thought he was winning, my Jesus came and said, "It is finished." My Jesus came,
hallelujah,
and said, "It is finished."
Let's go! Hey! Hallelujah! It is
victory. I hear the sound.
I hear the sound.
I hear the sound.
Why don't we appreciate the worship team, the children, the youth? Amen. Tell your neighbor, he is risen. He is not in the grave. Amen. Give Jesus a mighty hand clap. Amen. Amen. Thank you, worship team, and the youth and the children, for such an emotional and a vivid drama of what happened on Calvary. Let's appreciate them as they take their seats. Amen. Thank you very much. They have actually preached the message today for us, and I just want to summarize based on John chapter 19. I'll read verse 25 through 30. Now there stood by the cross of Jesus his mother and his mother's sister, Mary the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing by, he said to his mother, "Woman, behold your son." And he said to the disciple, "Behold your mother." And from that hour, that disciple took her to his home. After this, Jesus, knowing that all things were now accomplished, and the scripture had been fulfilled, said, "I thirst." Now a vessel full of sour vinegar was sitting there, and they filled a sponge with the sour wine, put it on the hyssop, and put it in his mouth. When Jesus had received the sour wine, he said, "It is finished." Bowing his head, he gave up his spirit. And I just want to focus on that phrase, "It is finished." Tell your neighbor, "It is finished." What was finished? The salvation of humanity, the deliverance of all of us. God said, "It is finished." There is nothing that remains to pay for your sins. There is nothing that remains for your deliverance. There is nothing that remains for you to attain the blessings of God. It is finished. Jesus Christ paid the full price that was expected of God to save humanity. He paid everything. And he paid it perfectly perfect. If there is something like that. He perfected our salvation and our deliverance. And if you understand this message, even as a believer, you are going to be free. As the word says in John chapter 8, verse 36, "He who the Son sets free shall be free indeed." And many believers even are struggling. They are still, they have received Jesus, but they are still looking for something extra to get a blessing, to get their doors open, to get opportunities. They are still looking for extra. There is nothing extra that is needed. It is finished. You don't need anyone else to help you. Jesus Christ gave you the help that was necessary. And you don't have to be afraid. You don't have to fear as a believer. All you need to do is to surrender to him. He demonstrated that love for us on the cross of Calvary. And even the people that were mocking, he forgave them. The people that did not believe in him, he told the Father, "Forgive them, for they do not know what they were doing," including the ones who crucified him. And this Easter season, would you consider surrendering your life to him? Because it is finished. You don't need religion. You don't need to go to a witch doctor to help you. Jesus Christ finished everything. You don't need to go to a witch doctor to protect you. With Jesus, you have perfect protection. It is finished. You don't need to go to a man to bless you. All the blessings of God come through Jesus Christ. Through this death on the cross, the storehouse of God was opened by Jesus Christ's death. And you can access it as you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and the Savior. So there is nothing that remains for you to be healed. There is nothing that remains for you to be saved. There is nothing that remains for you to be blessed. There is nothing that remains for you to enter eternal life. It was finished perfectly. Jesus paid it all. And yours and mine is just to receive. He has given you that love freely. He has loved us with an everlasting love. No wonder John wrote and asked, what manner of love is this? That a man would lay down his life for people that do not deserve, for people that are not even aware, for people that are not even concerned. He poured that love for us so that we might receive it. So the message I have for us is that this Easter season and this year and the years to come, it is finished. You don't need to add anything. You don't need to add anything to the salvation of Jesus Christ. He paid for your debts and for my debts. And all you need to do, all I need to do, is to come to him and say, I surrender my life. I accept your sacrifice. I give you my life. Take it and use it as you will. And you rest from your labors. As I said, even believers think that there is something extra they can do for God to love them. There is nothing more you can do for God to love you more. There is absolutely nothing, because Jesus Christ paid it all. And I want to appeal to us, those of you who have not taken opportunity to receive Jesus Christ as our Lord and the Savior. Baptism is not salvation. Going to church is not salvation. Being born in a Christian family is not salvation. Giving to the work of the Lord is not salvation. Serving the Lord is not salvation. You can even be a pastor and you are not born again. You can even dare to be a bishop and you are not born again. I have seen pastors get saved. So I want to challenge you, if you are here and you have not received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, this is your opportunity. Can you lift your hand? We want to see you. You came determined to receive Jesus Christ. And I said on Easter or Good Friday that if you don't give your life to the Lord, the devil is going to take it. It is just a matter of time. Anything that is not surrendered to Jesus, anything that is not surrendered to God, the devil, the enemy, has the authority and the power to take it from you. Because it is only Jesus who has the power. You saw the thief here, for whom there was contention, isn't it? The devil and his demons wanted to take him. But because Jesus Christ had put a mark on him, they could not manage. But for the ones who had not given their lives to the Lord, they were taken to hell. This team did an excellent job. So if you have not surrendered your life to the Lord, the enemy has the power and the authority to take it. And not only your life, but anything that you have not surrendered to the Lord, including your marriage, including your children, including your house, including your job, including your position. Anything that is not surrendered to God, the enemy can take it away anytime. He does not need to ask permission from anyone. So I don't know for how long you want to delay your salvation. Forget about what people are going to say. When you are being taken to hell, there is nobody who is going to be standing by your side. You'll go on alone. So is there anyone who wants to receive Jesus Christ? You are saying, I've been coming to church, but I have never confessed Jesus Christ as my Lord. Or you are saying, I have backslidden. I have not been walking faithfully with God. And I want to come back. You are like the prodigal son who went to eat with the pigs. But now you have remembered the love of your father and you want to come back home. Anyone like that? Lift your hand if you are there. Want to pray with somebody. Have I seen a hand? Yes, there is a hand there. Please come. Please come. Please come. Anyone else? Please come. Anyone else? Yes, let's appreciate him. He's a very bold man. Yes. Somebody else? Anyone else? I'll ask Pastor Mary to stand behind this young man and take his conduct so that we can disciple. Anyone else? Please come. Please come. Yes, they are coming. Bold believers. Karibu sana. Karibuni, yes. People are coming. Just face me. Stand facing me. Yes, there is a lady. Please come. There is a young girl. I don't know the young girl whether she is coming. Karibu sana. Quit Satan's club. And they say, I join Jesus' club. Anyone else? Please come. There's a moment of salvation. Jesus Christ came for you. Yes, there is a man who is coming. Amen. Amen. Let's give Jesus a mighty hand clap. We'll wait for you. Jesus paid it all. Who knows that chorus? Jesus paid it all. All to him. We can have a few people. Yes, Karibu, congratulations. Now you are a child of God. If you die today, you go to heaven. Anything you have not given to God, he is going to, the enemy is going to take it. So please don't waste time. Don't beat about the bush. The children of Israel went around the mountains for 40 years. A journey that would have taken them 11 days, took them 40 years. And that is what happens to us in life. As we delay receiving Jesus Christ and being aligned to his plans and the purposes, we go around in circles for 40 years. And we are still coming to church, but we are not receiving anything. Okay, I'll leave these ones to the Lord. Just pray after me. Lord Jesus Christ, I come to you. I acknowledge that I am a sinner. I invite you into my heart. Be my Lord and my Savior. I reject Satan and all his works. I ask you to write my name in the Lamb's Book of Life and help me to live for you and to serve you for the rest of my life. Baptize me with your Holy Spirit and give me victory over sin, over Satan, and over his principalities and demons. I ask this with thanksgiving in Jesus' name. Amen. Allow me to pray for them. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we want to thank you for this man. We want to thank you for this woman, O God. And your word declares that they that the Father has given to you, no one, no man, no woman, no demon, no principality will be able to snatch them from your hand. And Lord, I pray that you save them from whatever additions, from whatever habits that they might have adopted, O God. And Lord, I pray that you nurture them and disciple them in your word, O God, so that they might be strong believers in your kingdom. For your glory and for your honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I'll ask some two men to help us. Do you have counselors who are men? Amen. Yes. So I'll ask you to go to the side here, please. Just go to the side. They will share some words, take your names, and leave you. Let's all stand, please.
Find in me thine honor, Jesus.
Jesus made it all. Oh, to him I go. Sin I left a crimson storm. He washed it white as snow. Amen. For the rest of us, if we know Jesus Christ as our Lord and the Savior, we need to spread that message. It is very urgent. There are people who do not have that testimony, and we should not wait until they perish. And then we start regretting. I have heard of cases who have come, people who have come to the Lord in salvation, and they ask themselves, why was Sister so-and-so and Brother so-and-so keeping quiet? Knowing that I was headed to hell, they just kept quiet. So don't be accused of keeping quiet to the good news. Go and share the good news of Easter. Amen. Let's say the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. God bless you. You are dismissed. Happy Easter. I will meet on Sunday again. Karibuni.
Jesus made it all.